Good evening, my dear student. I hope you already have gone through the notes that I have sent you in exception handling. The concepts are quite critical. What is a compile time exception? What is runtime exception? How to use the try catch block? What is the meaning of throws finally? So the things getting a little bit complicated if I do not provide you an example. So in this class today, what I will do, I will tell you or show you little small program codes that will help you to understand the concepts of different types of compile time exception and runtime exception. So today I have set you a set of questions that generally comes to a student's mind. Okay, so let me share the screen first. So these are the questions that generally comes to a student's mind, that what are the different types of exceptions, what are the five keywords, what is the example of a compile time exception using a program, through a program we like to see what is a runtime exception, etc. So in five different installments I have already sent you the notes over last 2-3 weeks. So today, through programming, we'll see the concepts of these things, basically the answer of these first four questions. Later on in a next video I will give you the example of this. So today my target is to tell you the answer of these four, that what is the different types of exception, what are the keywords, what is a compile time exception, and what is a runtime exception. And these, especially 3 and 4, we like to see using a Java live program. That is what is my intention today, right? Okay, so let's start. Classify various kinds of exceptions. So this is the question that I would like to address first. Okay, so if this is done, then I will make it a bold. So what are the various types of exception? Let us try to understand using this example. So this is an example that I have set for you. Okay, so first, the superclass of any exception is the throwable class. Okay, it is inside java.lang package. So lang is a package which is inside the Java package. So java.lang.throwable. So I can say throwable is like the god class of the exception family. It is a super class of all type of compile time and runtime exception. Now it has mainly two child class. One is java.lang.error. Now these are not checked by the compiler. For example, virtual machine error, etc. So these are the system error that we cannot deal with. In our curriculum, we are interested about this family. What is exception and what are their child classes like this, right? So exception, it has many child classes. For example, java.lang.io exception, java.lang.interrupted exception, java.lang.runtime exception, etc. Now you see, I have bifurcated them using this red line. Now, what is the meaning of these? That java.lang.runtime exception, this particular class and all its child class, for example, java.lang.arithmetic exception, index out of bounds exception, there is a child class of index out of bounds, that is java.lang.array index out of bounds exception. There are many class cast exception, null pointer exception, blah, blah, blah. All these things are nothing but child class of, or the descendant class of, runtime exception. They are not checked in the time of compilation. They are detected in the time of execution. That's why they are called the runtime exception. Other than this runtime exception, whatever be the child class of java.lang.exception, for example, IO exception class, interrupted exception class, they are all, you see, compile time exception. So I repeat once again, throwable has two child. One is error that we are not dealing with. They are not checked by compiler, or we cannot fix them using programming. We are interested in the exception class, which is itself a compile time exception. Remember, java.lang.exception is a compile time exception. Now it has many subclasses, IO exception, interrupted exception, runtime exception, etc., etc. Among these, runtime exception and all its child class, they are considered as the runtime exception or execution time exception. Other than these, the remaining subclasses of exception, for example, IO exception, interrupted exception, they are considered as compile time exception. So I hope this hierarchy is clear. Now I can show you a live example from the java.lang.api, right? So here, if I go there, java.lang package, and if I find what is an exception class, what is an exception class? So there, you see this exception class, this is very, very interesting. This is the live example that I'm showing you from the Java original API. This is the manual of Java programming language. Now you see exception. Now you see the exception class, it has many direct known subclasses. So many exceptions are there. Please don't get panicked. You no need to remember all these subclasses. Nobody remembers this. Okay, so what is important? What I'm trying to show you that out of all these, there are one class, which is the runtime exception class, which is the runtime exception class, which is shown here. Which one is that? Find it out. Yes, this one. This runtime exception is itself a runtime exception that is not checked in the time of compilation. All other remaining classes, for example, interrupted exception, for example, IO exception, they are all compile time exception. Only this class, runtime exception, I click on the runtime exception. So this is nothing but an example of a runtime exception, and all its direct known subclasses. Already, I think I have given you some example. For example, arithmetic exception, okay, that has been written here. Okay, for example, index out of bounds exception. For example, where is the index out of bound exception? Let me find this out. INDEX, right? Index out of bounds exception. Okay, they are all the direct subclasses of the runtime exception. Okay, so they are the example of runtime exception. So students, I hope that you have understood what are the different types of exception. Probably it has two child class, one is error and another is exception. Now exception has many subclasses. Only one is the runtime exception that is not checked in the time of compilation. So runtime exception and all its child classes are runtime exceptions itself. And other than these, whatever be the child classes of exceptions like IO exception, interrupted exception, they are checked at the time of compilation. So they are called compile time exception. Okay, fine. So now I go to the next question, that what are the five important keywords in this chapter? Okay, so let me make this bold, because this is being answered right now. Remember, there are five keywords altogether. There are total five keywords. Okay, so in this chapter, and what are they? Try. I think you know this thing already. Try, then catch. If you have gone through my notes, you know this thing. Throws, they are the most important five keywords. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Try, catch, throw, throws, finally, that we read in this chapter. Now, very, very important. Please pay attention that give an example of a compile time exception. This example I will give you live through a program. This is not that IO exception is a compile time exception, bookie's answer. That I want to give you. I want to give you a complete example. Okay. And for that, I will use this Eclipse platform. This is an editor. Here, I can do the coding very easily. Otherwise, if I type in the notepad, it will take much time. So, this is the first example. So, I give it just a name first. The name of the class is first. Okay. So, here I will show you a compile time exception. If you remember that if I want to take an input in the class, how to take an input using BufferedReader class, and there I use a method called readline. That readline method is associated with a compile time exception, that is IO exception. If we do not write down the try catch block, or if we do not write down the throws keyword, then it will give you an compile time error immediately. So let me try this. Suppose I take the roll number of a student, right? So integer roll, and then BUFF year. So this is an editor. Quickly, I will get this thing. Buffered reader beer. So you see, import java.io.bufferedReader. This I have done in my regular classes before there was any lockdown. I took some regular classes, and there I think I have shown you this thing. Okay, so I'm not going to explain you this thing much because BufferedReader is in java.io package, so I have to import this thing. So BufferedReader br equal to new BufferedReader within bracket new. I hope you remember it. Input stream reader. Then system.in, right? Dot buffer reader br equal to new buffer reader, new input stream reader, system.in. This already I have done in my class. Now I will take the input system.out.println. So this is the editor where I can type very quickly. Otherwise, if I use a notepad, this will take much time. Okay, enter. The same program can be done using notepad also. You can try this thing in notepad also. Enter the role. So role equal to, this will be an integer number. So I will be using integer integer dot parseInt, and what I will write there, I will write there br dot, yes, this br dot readline. So I will take the input, right? Now you see, I am getting an error here. I am getting a red line in Eclipse that suggests that I am getting an error. What is the error? You see, add throws declaration or surround with try catch. Why? Because this read line is associated with a compile time exception. Until unless we deal with that exception during the time of compilation, this will give you an error. This program will not compile at all. Okay. So once again, if I go there, okay, then if I go to the java.io package and I go to the buffered reader class, BUFFERED, buffered reader class, and in the class, if I go through the various methods, one of the method is the readline method. You see readline method, I click on the readline method and this thing comes, public string readline throws IO exception. Clearly Java tells you, the manual tells you that the IO exception is associated with this, right? So I copy and I write this thing here, that readline method that is associated with the IO exception. Until unless you deal with this exception, and what type of exception this is, from this I already know that this IO exception is nothing but a compile time exception. You see, this thing has been mentioned here. So I have to deal with this. So what should I do? Eclipse suggests that add with the throws or try catch block. I will go for the try catch block. I click this here and I get this thing. These things are not necessary right now. So this is number format exception, blah, blah, all these things are not needed right now, simply. Okay, so now you see this thing. Okay. So I right click and I source and then I format it. Okay, now you see this thing. So readline method and that compilation error is vanished because this exception, IO exception, is associated with this, and I have surrounded this thing with a proper try catch block. Okay. So similarly, if I write, there is another, for example, thread.sleep, and I need to give how much time. So this, don't worry, I will teach you thread when the chapter will come, you see it is giving error. And if I put there, what it is telling? Unhandled exception type uninterrupted exception, because with this slip method, an exception, compile time exception is associated, that is interrupted exception. Once again, if I go through this and I go to the thread method, thread class, and I find out the slip method, the same thing will happen. Same thing will happen. You will see that it is written there, interrupted exception, right? So I put it using a try catch block, and what I get is something like this. Okay, you see, and try catch block, and these things are not necessary. Simply, if I put this thing, and the error is vanished. So compile time exception is associated with slip. That is nothing but an interrupted exception. Okay, what has been mentioned here? Interrupted exception. So until unless I write a try catch block or I write a throws keyword, so I do not take care of it, at the it will not compile at all. Okay, so guys, I think you have understood the concept of compile time exception, and this is a very very crucial concept, runtime exception. Please try, put your focus and understand the concept. What is a runtime exception? Okay, so for this I will open up another class. For example, say the name of the class is second. Okay, so runtime exceptions are not checked in the time of compilation. So it will perfectly compile. Even if you do not write any try catch program, it will perfectly compile, but there are issues. What will happen if there is any runtime exception in the time of execution? Okay, so without wasting time, let us give you an proper example. I think the idea will be clear. For example, I want to divide two number. Okay, integer a equal to 20 and integer b equal to 10, fine. And then I want to print this thing, system.out.println. Okay, system.out.println. Okay, and plus a by b. Okay, so now I want to execute this thing. Okay, and then I write that dot out dot println. Okay, write end of, fine. Absolutely fine. Now if I execute this program, okay, obviously what will happen? 20 by 10. So the output is 2. Clearly you can see, and this is the end of program. Fine. But if I make this 0, then what will happen? This is a runtime issue. 20 by 0, it cannot execute. You see? And immediately throws an exception, java.lang.arithmetic exception divide by 0. So this is nothing but java.lang.arithmetic exception. This is a runtime exception. Okay. So this is different than IO exception, or different than interrupted exception. There I have to provide the try catch block, otherwise the program will not compile. But here it compiles, fine. But depending on the value of b, it depends whether it will throw an exception or not. So in this case, I may provide a try catch block. If I provide a suitable try catch block, the control will pass to the catch block and the program will continue. Okay, so what I can do, I can write a try catch block, okay, and I can put this thing here. I can put this thing here, and in the catch block, I can, what is the exception that we are getting? Arithmetic exception. Arithmetic exception E, and there I can give the message. Sorry, divide by 0. Okay, and then the end of the program. So this is the program that we have written. Let me make it proper format little bit, source and then format, right. Now you see what happens if this is 10, Then normal 20 by 10, no arithmetic exception is generated. So the control does not go to the catch block. Simply the control passes to the end of program. So I execute this. Please follow this thing. What is the output you are getting? You see, to and end of program. Fine. But now, if this thing is zero, what will happen? During division, a runtime exception will be generated, that arithmetic exception. And immediately from here, the control will pass to here. So if I write something here, dot out dot println, suppose if I write here ABC, okay, ABC, this line will not appear because the exception will be caught here and immediately the control will pass to here. This line will not be executed at all because 20 by 0, immediately arithmetic exception will arise and that will be passed to the catch block. Okay, so let us execute this program and you see what happens. So you see, A by B, that is arithmetic exception, the immediately the next line ABC, that is not printed over here. Immediately the control is passed to the catch block, that is arithmetic exception, sorry, divide by zero, and then the program goes on normally. Okay. Now if this is 10, then I execute this thing. So this is 2, then the next line is executed, ABC. Obviously, the control is not passed to the catch block because no arithmetic exception and end of program. This is what the output you will get. So last week I have given you assignment. Every program I have asked you to write down what will be the output if there is an exception, if there is no exception. Okay. And the whole thing, what I can do, I can remove this try catch block. I can show you. I can remove this try catch block. Everything I can remove. Okay. Everything I can remove, it is absolutely fine. Now, what will happen if there is no exception? Fine, this will execute, okay? 2 ABC end of program. But if there is any exception, remember, there is no matching catch block. I repeat once again, there is no matching catch block. So obviously an arithmetic exception will be generated here and there is no matching catch block. So immediately the program will stop and it will be passed to the default exception handler, okay? So you see the program stops, okay, and because 20 by 0 cannot be computed and the control will go to the default exception handler. Okay, so that means, so today I have in my video lecture class, I tried to make the concept of these four programs. Please go through this. So in my next video lecture, I will tell you the remaining thing, that what is the meaning of multiple try catch block or finally block or throws keyword and all these things. Okay. So I hope you enjoyed the concepts of compile and runtime exceptions. Go through this in the next video. I will come back soon with the remaining concepts. Thank you very much.